Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how a website, specifically a web server, works. This is picking up where we left off in my last video on how does the internet work. And in that video, I showed you the high-level concept of how a website works. Having the section here that where the HTTP request goes into the web server and gives you back the website. So what's actually happening right there with that web server? Well, the question we're going to answer is what happens with this HTTP request that's coming in? HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and it's the protocol used to basically communicate the web back and forth. And like I said in the last video, there is also HTTPS, which is just a secured version of that protocol. So when that request comes in, it's going to be coming into a web server. And so obviously the very basics of what we need for this web server to work is a server. So at the very bottom level here, we have our server. And our server is comprised of normal hardware that you would find in your everyday computer, except it's going to be higher grade and ready to handle higher traffic than what your normal computer would be. Now on top of that server, it's going to be an operating system. Or an OS for short. Now there's several different types of operating systems that could be on this server. It could be running a version of Windows, or more likely, it's running a version of Linux. Now, there's different variations of Windows and Linux that could be running the web server. You could be running like something like Red Hat or CentOS or Ubuntu for Linux. Different common things, but most likely, it's going to be running Linux. That's what I would say is the backbone of the internet. Now, on top of the operating system, it's going to be our web service. Now the web service is what communicates with the operating system. The operating system is what communicates with the server. So the web service is going to be something on a Windows server. It would most likely be IIS, which is Internet Information Systems. Or on Linux, most likely, Apache. And these are web services that run on these operating systems so that we can continue on with building our web server. Now on top of the web service, it's going to be a coding language. Now for coding languages, this could be something as simple, basically, ultimately, our goal is to get to HTML code. Our coding language could just be HTML, which in that case, on our web server, we would have an index.html file. And when the HTTP request comes in, it would grab this file and send it back through the internet back to your computer. But more modern day websites don't run just pure HTML. There's another coding language that's going to build the site dynamically to output an HTML file that it'll send back to you. And so the coding languages that I'm speaking of here would be something like PHP, Perl, ASP, C, C#. The list goes on of possible coding languages that would be that'll actually run on the server and output this HTML file that you actually see on the website. Now, another layer on top of this coding language could be a content management system, or CMS for short. Probably will recognize the term WordPress. There's other content management systems. WordPress is one of the most popular. And what WordPress does is it creates a graphical interface for you to create and edit your website without having to know one of these coding languages. So WordPress and other content management tools are powerful because they let you create dynamic looking sites without having to know coding languages. Now WordPress is built on PHP, so let's go ahead and make that connection there. And WordPress also uses another technology called a database. And so on this server, you may also have a database. We'll just say DB for short. And WordPress is going to require a database in order to function. Now you could write your own website code without needing a database, but most likely an advanced website or anything that has like products or a vast amount of information is going to need a central database so that your code has a central place to talk to and has a place to get information from. So in this case, after we get through all these layers, the content management system will produce our output, or our HTML code. So the request will come into the server, and we will send it back the final rendered HTML code page. Now this outputted HTML code, it could also contain, let's just say this output, it's going to contain HTML code. It could also contain JavaScript, CSS, and possibly some other client-side coding languages. Now, here we had a coding language, and here we have client-side languages. And the difference is these languages, you as a person browsing the internet would never experience these languages. You'd never be able to see this code. But this is the code that's sent back to you. And so things like HTML is what your browser reads, JavaScript your browser reads. Some more advanced JavaScript actually requires you to download the Java application, which you may have on your computer. CSS is what gives it the visual graphics and colors and stuff like that. And so these languages are actually sent back, as in our previous video, are sent back through the internet to your web browser so that you can actually get content displayed on your web browser. So if you want to know more about any one of these parts of a web server, leave a comment either in the comments below or go to my website at techtipguru.com. There's a form there. You can ask a question about any of these languages. Some of them I'm more familiar with than others, but I'd be happy to at least help point you in the right direction if you need help with one of them or if you just have more questions. Let me know if you're interested. Maybe I'll make some more videos on some of these different concepts. And I am definitely working on a HTML video so to teach some of the basics about HTML code, since it is something you will encounter on the web, whether you're programming server-side applications or whether you're building out websites in WordPress. You will need to know HTML code. That's my video on the basics of how a website, specifically a web server, works. Thank you for watching.